2 years ago, they would have said, no, no way, you're not touching my car. Now they're considering it. Again, the best experience, rather than just talk about it, is to have people sit in the car.
So we started with the Porsche 911 because it was a very expensive vehicle, shall we say, that people were happy to spend a considerable amount of money on the conversion. It's sort of like a Tesla model, I suppose, where you start with a high-value car, you fine-tune your manufacturing techniques, and then you can do it to more and more mass market. So the Porsche was the first one we did that with, which is still building today. But we do about 25 to 30 Porsche kits a year, I think is our target as of for next year.
We need to make sure people understand that our system are designed to be fully reversible. So when you remove the transmission, the engine and the fuel tank, you keep them on the side and we only use OEM holes or screw mounts and fixing. Just because in the UK you cannot modify the chassis of the car to convert a classic car anyway. So there's no drilling or anything to install the high voltage system, for instance. So if you have a very high value car that you want to convert for, say, 5 years and enjoy every single day because it starts every time you want to use it, so be it. And then in 5 years time, when you want to sell on the car, not that anybody has ever done it, but you can remove the system, put the ICE system back in, or maybe a new technology will come up and use this new technology in 5 to 10 years time. Maybe we have more energy dense batteries, for instance. So, well, the most important thing and the way our retailers, the installers that use our system, the best way for them to sell conversion is to have people drive the vehicle. There's no, I mean, you can talk about it as much as you want. Once you sit in a car, a converted car is just the most fun thing you can ever do because you get all the torque you would get from a classic car, all the power. And also it's very quiet. So you start to learn how to drive again your car and enjoy it again. And as I was saying earlier, your car is charged up every morning when you want to take it to work, when you want to go on a trip. You don't have to worry if it's going to start that morning or if you want to take it on a long drive, if you want to take it on holidays, you have fast charging like brand new cars in your classic cars, meaning you can go across the country without thinking twice, you can just leave.
And what would you say to some of the classic car fans that still insist its original beauty and fun is in the ICE car rather than electric? What do you explain to people who resist the idea of converting into electric?
2 years ago, they would have said, no, no way, you're not touching my car. They're considering it. Again, the best experience, rather than just talk about it, is to have people sit in the car.
I could do that all day. It is absolutely unbelievable.
So, we started 2018. It was myself, Alex Darwood, my business partner. We started because we won a contract to do 3 stunt vehicles for a show in Macau. That then sort of bankrolled us and allowed us to start moving into technological developments around the EV conversion market, which at that point there was no systems out there. Nothing really talked to each other. Nothing really, just nothing synced up properly. So we saw a gap in the market at that point whilst we were doing the stunt vehicles to start developing products that allowed different components to work correctly together, and started educating the more general public or the sort of the conversion shops so they could understand that actually these products work with each other, these ones don't, and start trying to build some systems around that and the software and the hardware to allow integration. That then we carried on then in the stunt film industry, so we've done an awful lot in for Warner Brothers, Disney, Universal Pictures, stuff like that for stunt vehicles for films. But that really allowed us to do a lot of rapid prototyping. Because we were doing stunt vehicles, they would only go on the road for a month or two to do filming, and then they get taken apart again. But it allowed us to find the limits of systems and components very quickly, and work out where we could push things and what we could achieve with the right budget in place. And then after that, we then started thinking about where we were going to go as a company to actually build a bigger company from it, rather than just build one-off vehicles. So we started down the design development and eventually now moving into the manufacturing of complete systems. And then we got approached by BMW Mini in the UK to do some vehicles for their advertising department, which became Recharge Heritage. So we built 5 vehicles, 3 prototypes, one for Paul Smith, one for Laquena. We've now been building mini kits for multiple companies and customers all over the world, in which I think we do about 50 of them per year at the moment. And we're now moving into Land Rover Defenders and Series vehicles, which we'll be releasing next year for one of our clients who's going to be doing brand new vehicles into the US market. But alongside that, we started producing universal battery packs, which were designed to fit the Land Rover, and we soon realized they'd fit multiple other vehicles. So we started ramping up production now of our universal battery pack, which drops into most 4x4s.
And I think it will be one way, sooner than we anticipate, to keep classic cars on the road. Because with a classic car, for instance, you can still drive into London, but soon they're changing the rules where even older ICE cars or classic cars won't be able to go in London. The only way you will be able to drive your classic car in main cities in Europe and eventually in the United States will be to have a converted to EV classic car. Well, the funny thing is what we call a classic car today, in 10 or 20 years, it will be still the cars of today. So with classic cars comes a generation, and 20 years later, it's a new generation of classic cars. So even today, a brand new Golf, a Nissan, for us, ICE car, for us, it's just a brand new car. But for the younger Indians that can buy those cars in 20 years, they would still love them. They will still want potentially to convert them if they haven't been converted. So I think we'll be converting cars in 10 or 15 years still, because there will be so many classic cars to convert.